Defoe! Oh no! Unbelievably, it has been pushed out to Staltieri, and with seconds remaining, West Ham's fate might well have been sealed. Still a big crowd in the East End. They haven't lost faith in terms of turning up in their huge numbers. But I suspect if you ask most of these West Ham fans whether they really believe their side can stay in the Premiership, the answer would be no. West Ham winning most of the midfield battles at the moment. Chesky. Tevez sets it up for Noble, and this time there was nothing Robinson could do to stop him. It's Tevez, and it's absolutely magnificent. What a way to get your first goal. What a day to do it. He'll pick up a yellow card as well, but does he care? It'll be the most unpopular goal scored at Upton Park this season if he gets it. Game on. To Berbatov, two in the middle. One of them is Lennon. And it's a goal, and a superb goal as well by Tainio. Chesky can't get his foot to the ball for the challenge. Very relieved to see it not wide by Staltieri.
It's been positive from Alan Kurbishley. I'd say he's got his four strikers on now. Blanco, Tevez, Harewood, Zamora. There's one who isn't. Still would like to be part of the proceedings out there. Teddy Sheringham.
With his huge experience, he'll know how vital it is now, these last few minutes, that West Ham somehow or other find the spark they had in the opening 45. Any kind of goal will do now. They won't care how it's scored. Tevez will take the free kick. It's not bad, it was tempting, and it's a goal! They've done it, and it's Bobby Zamora who's come off the bench and within 2 minutes has scored the most important goal West Ham have got this season.
Well, would you believe it? It's got to be his first touch of the ball. It's a decent delivery into the box by Tevez, and he rises well, gets up early. It's the first time we've seen the Tottenham players beating it at the back. And it's a powerful header that gives Robinson no chance. Look at the reaction. Look what it means to Robert Green and his team.
Well, it was his goal that earned West Ham their place in the Premier League in the playoff final a couple of years ago. Will that goal keep them in the Premier League? There's still an awful lot for West Ham to do today. Never mind in their remaining games, but that is a precious, precious header by Bobby Zamora, who is as much a West Ham United fan as all those who celebrated the goal with him. Tottenham rock back on their heels again. They must have believed that at the worst they'd take a point here. Still could, of course. But the impetus is now back with the Hammers, and they've got a free kick.
Well, that's credit Alan Kurbishley as well, because we talked about his bravery, we talked about him having the four strikers up there. And it was this man, Bobby Zamora, the latest addition. We've got that important header. You'll see he's teamed up with Tainio, and that's maybe what gives him just that height advantage. He gets up early, meets him perfectly, and you can see he gives Robinson absolutely no chance.
His seventh goal of the season, and far and away the most important. Harewood has considered a free kick here. Tevez gesticulating and Encouraging.
He wants to know which side he's playing. Am I left? Am I right?
Yeah.
I think Alan Kirby's saying just run around. Just make sure we get this result.
And Egert Magnussen, the owner, rises to his feet and looks anxiously at his watch all at the same time. And here's quite a moment for this young man, Adel Tarapt, who's just 17. His debut is on loan from Lyon in the French League. A lot of Premiership clubs and indeed clubs throughout Europe have been eyeing him, apparently. Tottenham got there first. Difficult situation to come on in, that's for sure. Tevez has dropped into midfield. Konchesky. What they won't want to see now is a big figure when that board goes up to indicate stoppage time. All West Ham want now is that final whistle. A goal out of the blue has given them a hope again. But here comes Huddleston for Tottenham. He claimed a handball there. Well, they'll get a free kick anyway for that second challenge on Tarrant.
This boy can play, by the way. Slipped a ball in, got it back, wanted it again. Look at the feet, look at the composure for what somebody so young. Earned his team a free kick right on the edge of the box.
Nobody will have left early at Upton Park. There could be another chapter written in this dramatic story yet. Green indicating he wants five by the looks of it in the wall.
I just wonder if you put a couple of people on the post. I know you're going to get crowded, but I feel at this late stage of the game, it might just be the difference, somebody heading one off the line.
Berbatov concentrates hard. There's no question he's got the ability to do what Tevez did in the first half. And that he has done! Dimitar Berbatov with a magnificent free kick. Tottenham are level and West Ham are back in despair.
Well, anything Tevez can do, Berbatov shows he's his equal, because this is even harder. It's closer to get that up and down. And I talked about somebody on the line. Well, they got Konchesky there, but it was just too good for him. The ball was too high and he could only help it on its way. And what a blow that is for Alan Kirbishley. I think he knows with that goal could go West Ham's chances of staying in this English Premier League.
And he knows too. Berbatov's 16th goal of what has been an excellent first season at White Hart Lane. Well, there'll be a fair amount of stoppage time, so, well, your guess is as good as mine, which way this game could go now.
Well, for the neutral, it's been a brilliant game, hasn't it?
It has.
Not quite sure if you're a West Ham fan, you'd be saying the same.
And you wouldn't have been saying that at half-time if you were a Tottenham fan, that's for sure. Here come the Hammers again, though. Zamora's once again in a good position here, and so too is Marlon Harewood. Oh, Noble almost got onto that. Tevez did. Oh, what a chance. 4 minutes of stoppage time.
Well, the way the game was going for this fella, you almost thought this is going to end up in the back of the net. First touch is brilliant. Wow, it's inches away. Absolutely inches. Just fears away from the post at the last minute. It's a super strike. Oh, and look at the reaction.
Well, if you wonder why this is the greatest game in the world, wonder no longer, because we have seen here today a match of remarkable excitement, entertainment and quality. And it ain't over yet. And Defoe, well, I was about to say, looked as though he'd beaten the offside trap. He didn't, though.
No, he was clearly off. Wasn't able to make the most of the opportunity, but what, with 3 minutes on the clock, is there one last chance? Is there somebody going to emerge a hero?
Tevez. Got to get it forward now, West Ham. Doesn't have to be pretty. Gardner's header away, drops to Lennon. Surely there's not going to be one more twist in this incredible tale. Anyway, we'll do for Davenport.
I'm afraid having led 2-0 and having led 3-2, even a 3-all draw is going to seem like a defeat for these West Ham players and the fans. It's definitely two that got away.
A roller coaster of emotions they've gone through today, haven't they? And as you rightly say, if you're a neutral, five-star entertainment this. That's a foul. West Ham free kick. Play on, says Mr. Dean. Zamora uses his strength to find a way through. Still, what, 90 seconds or thereabouts? Of an incredible 90 minutes, and it's given away. Lennon getting forward in support for Defoe here. Had to win that tackle, Ferdinand. He'd never have been forgiven. Defoe, surely not here of all people, about to put West Ham to the sword. Huddleston wins it back. He did really well. And here's the youngster showing his skill on the ball again, although a bit of a theatrical dive, which Lucas Neal didn't appreciate. But Tarap's already shown us why he's so highly rated. He can't look now. That's a foul, wasn't it, by Gardner? It was. Is this the final twist in the tale?
Well, this is the last chance. Pile them up, get them in there, get a delivery. Give your teammates a chance. I think that's all you can ask at this stage.
Well, we've seen two quite remarkably brilliant free kicks in this game. Are we about to see one more? This will surely be the final moment of drama in the match, and they realise that. We've had the allotted stoppage time of 4 minutes. Surely, whatever happens here, it'll be over. It's Konchesky who strikes it through the wall. And has that gone for a corner?
I think it came off Dawson. West Ham corner. Cue the big man forward. Possibly cue Robert Green.
Hope Mr. Dean doesn't do a Clive Thomas and blow in the balls in mid-air here. The last throw of the dice, it's Lucas Neal who hurls himself at it. And still the referee won't blow that whistle. And Zamora's lost out here. The referee looks at his watch as he races forward. It's Jermaine Defoe, and he's got Lennon up with him, and only Konchesky to beat at the moment. Defoe! Oh, no! Unbelievably, it has been pushed out to Staltieri, and with seconds remaining, West Ham's fate might well have been sealed, not just on the day, but for the season. What a body blow that is.
Well, look on the manager's face tells it all. They lose a ball on the edge of the box, and in fairness to Tottenham, look how many white shirts break forward. Defoe knows these runners round him, but he likes to take the shot on, and just when Robert Green needs a bit of luck, he doesn't get it. He gets his hand to the ball, and you see it just gets away from him. Solteri, who's run the length of the field, gets a simple tap in. And the shake of the head from Alan Curvetley tells you that he knows this game's gone.
It's only the third goal he's ever scored for Tottenham Hotspur, and it's the goal that might well send West Ham United out of the Barclays English Premier League. Remember, the stoppage time allocated originally was 4 minutes. Well, only the referee can arbitrate about how much more he adds to that. We've already had over 2 minutes. We thought West Ham were going to get the final opportunity. We were wrong. It fell to Tottenham, and West Ham have fallen to another defeat.